Shepard, it's good to see you again. So, what can I do for you?
I know you're looking for the Shadow Broker. Cerberus gave me data on where to find him. Interested?
Absolutely. I had no idea. Let me see what you've got. It looks like a leaked transmission between Shadow Broker operatives. Some hints as to the location and... It's about Farron. He's still alive.
Who's Farron?
He was a friend. He helped me recover your body from the Shadow Broker.
Why did the Shadow Broker want my corpse?
He was going to sell you to the Collectors, but Farron and I stopped him. Farron sacrificed himself to save me.
So you rescued me? Then how did I end up with Cerberus?
Well, they gave me intel to help recover you. They actually put Farron with me in the first place. After I got out, I gave you to them. They said they could bring you back.
So, you're the one responsible for me ending up with Cerberus? Why?
Cerberus knew you and I. They said they could bring you back. They gave me a sliver of hope. Was I supposed to just leave you dead? They brought you back. And now they're giving me a chance to find Farron. After 2 years, I hadn't even dreamed.
If he's been the Shadow Broker's prisoner for 2 years, he may not be in good shape.
I know. But yesterday, all I wanted was the chance to avenge his death. Today, he's alive. I'll do whatever I have to do to get him back.
Sounds like you and Farron were close.
It's funny. He betrayed me more than once. He was double-dealing for Cerberus, for the Shadow Broker. But in the end, he sacrificed himself for me. I owe him.
Any friend of yours is a friend of mine. What's the next step?
I don't know. I need to prepare, to think. I'm going home. Use my terminal if you need any local intel.
You okay?
I've spent 2 years plotting revenge. Now I have the chance to make it a rescue.
Let me help. I'll come by your apartment.
Okay. Hopefully I'll have a plan by then. Thank you, Shepard.
Seal off those trace samples and get them back to the lab.
We got multiple shots fired. Yeah, techs are going over the place now.
Central, we got an open carrier on this end. Switching to a coded relay.
What's going on?
This area is sealed off. Please step back, sir.
Sealed off? Why?
Someone tried to kill your friend, Commander Shepard. Thank you, officer. Your people are dismissed.
You can't do that.
Already done. Tila Vasir, Special Tactics and Recon.
A Spectre?
I heard your status was reinstated. Good. You're one of our most famous operatives. Might even get you to sign my chest plate. So, I assume you had business with your friend this evening, Commander.
Liara was following a lead on the Shadow Broker.
The Shadow Broker? Dangerous enemy to have.
What are the facts so far?
About 25 minutes ago, someone took a shot at Tisoni. Note the bullet holes. She stuck around for almost 4 minutes before leaving the building. Whatever she was doing was important.
Did the police find anything when they arrived?
Just the mess and the bullet holes. I gave them a gold star for finding the bullet holes.
If Liara isn't here, where is she?
If I knew that, I wouldn't be sifting through her crap. There's no blood, no body. It looks like Tisoni got away. The sniper didn't plan on her kinetic barrier. Clever girl. Paranoid, but clever.
What did you find on Liara's terminal?
Not much. She wiped her drive before she left.
Liara knew I was coming. She'd have made a backup of whatever she found.
Makes sense. Haven't found it yet, though. You knew Tisoni better than I do. Where would she have hidden her backups?
Let me take a look around.
The picture changed when you touched it. It must be keyed to your ID. What does it show now?
It's a Prothean dig site. Liara did leave a message.
There are a few Prothean-looking objects around the apartment. Let's see what we can find.
Vasir, I've got something here.
Backup disk. Let's try it on her terminal. It looks like she recorded a call.
What have you got for me, Sagat?
It was tricky, but you paid for the best. I can narrow it down to a cluster, maybe even a system.
How soon can you have it?
Shouldn't take long. Come to my office. Barrier Frontiers in the Dracon Trade Center. Gotta say, though, Tassoni, you're making me a little nervous. How big is the trouble that could come out of this?
Relax, Sagat. I'll see you in a few hours.
Sounds like Liara found something big on the Shadow Broker.
And then someone found her. I know where the Dracon Trade Center is. My car's outside.
Let's go.
The Barrier Frontiers offices are located on the third floor. I don't hear police chatter. We must have missed the party.
Liara's in there!
There, now it's getting fun.
They just took out three floors to make sure she's dead. I'll grab this guy car and seal off the building from the top.
I'll start down here and work my way up.
Just leave some for me. Damn it. If I'd have been a few seconds faster, I could have stopped them.
Is this Sagat?
Must have been.
No sign of that data Liara talked about. Looks like a dead end.
Speaking of which, did you find your friend's body?
You mean this body?
Liara. Something I should know?
This is the woman who tried to kill me.
You've had a rough day, so I'll let that slide. Why don't you put that gun down?
I saw you. I doubled back after I left. I watched you break into my apartment.
So what? You were just using me to find the message?
Nothing personal, Shepard. Just needed a little help tracking down Liara.
Once she had my location, she signaled the Shadow Broker's forces. They bombed the building to take me out. She found Sagat, took his data, and killed him. I'm guessing she's still got the disc on her.
Good guess. Not that you'll ever see what's on it. You pure-blood bitch!
I'm fine, by the way. Thanks for asking.
Thank you. I crashed on Azure. Get me some damn backup.
Vizier, it's over.
Hey! Hey, you! Come here. What's your name?
Mariana.
Mariana, you want to live, don't you? Tell those people that you want to live. Now it gets ugly.
Please, I have a son.
A son. I hope he gets to see you again. I've heard losing a parent is just horrific for children. Scars them for life.
I'm going to end you, Vizier.
It's okay, Liara. We'll handle it. The usual way.
You want Mariana's little boy to grow up without a mommy, Shepard?
You girls should really just stick to dancing. You know, play to your strengths.
Drop the clips!
I'm gonna kill your hostage, Vizier.
Damn it!
You'll live.
Ah! Damn it! Damn it!
Sakat's personal datapad. This has what we need to find the Shadow Broker.
You're dead! The Shadow Broker has been in power for decades. He's stronger than anything you've ever faced.
Is that why you sold out the Council to work for him?
You think I betrayed the Council? Like Saren? Go to hell. The Broker's given me damn good intel over the years. Intel that saved lives and kept the Citadel safe. So if the Broker needs a few people to disappear, I'll pay that price without hesitation.
Tell yourself whatever you like. The Council would never accept you working for the Shadow Broker.
The Council? You pay them lip service while working for terrorists? You have any idea what Cerberus has done?
The Council wasn't looking out for human interests. Somebody had to.
Human interests? I read the files, Shepard. Kidnapping kids for biotic death camps? Killing Alliance admirals who ask questions? And you're with them. Don't you dare judge me. Don't you?
Eliminate Tassoni and retrieve the data. Civilian casualties not a concern.
Vizier's dead.
I'm putting the data through to the Normandy's computers. We can be at the Shadow Broker's base in a few hours. He'll know about Vizier before long. If he decides to kill Farron.
We'll get Farron out of there alive, Liara. I promise.
I know. You're here to help. Just like always.
That's not a good thing?
When we first met on Therum, you saved me from the Geth. You fought a Krogan battlemaster while I cowered. Now you're doing it again. And I'm still leaning on you for help.
That's what friends do, Liara.
I can get us there based on Sakat's data. The Normandy's stealth drive will keep them from detecting us. The Shadow Broker's agents are still shooting their way through Ilium. With luck, they won't notice we've left until it's too late.
That's a little cold. They killed innocent people.
You know what I mean.
Do I? When I hit the ground back at the Trade Center, you went after Vizier without a backward look.
A little fall wasn't going to kill you. I had to stay on Vizier. I had to stay rational, make the call, like I did with Sakat.
That's Vizier's fault, not yours.
Sakat had no idea what the stakes were. I put him in harm's way to get the data I needed. I got him killed. And I'd do it again. But from here on out, things will be simple. Get in, get Farron, get out. And kill anyone who tries to stop us.
That's it?
That's it.
Will you just stop for a second? We'll be jumping several light years. There's time to talk.
About what?
About us.
Shepard, listen, I'm glad you're here.
You worried there might be terminals you need me to hack?
That's not fair. You were dead.
I came back.
It's not that easy. You can't just come back and have 2 years of mourning suddenly vanish. I'm sorry, Shepard. I can't get into this. For now, let's just focus on getting Farron back.
Fine.
Come fly with me, let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come on and fly with me, let's fly away. Come fly with me, let's float down to Peru. In Llama Land, there's a one-man band, and he'll toot his flute for you. Come on, fly with me, let's take off in the blue. Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide starry-eyed. Once I get you up there, I'll be holding you so near. You may hear all the angels cheer, because we're together. Weather-wise, it's such a lovely day. Just say the words and we'll beat the birds down to Acapulco Bay. It is perfect for a flying honeymoon. They say, come fly with me, let's fly away.
Oceans boil during the day, then snap freeze 10 minutes after sundown.
The Shadow Broker lives in this?
His ship follows the sunset, completely undetectable in the storm, unless you know where to look.
How do we get inside?
The shuttle bay is locked down. We'll need to land on the ship and hunt for a hatch. But we can't stay outside for long. There's a constant lightning storm where the hot and cold air collide. It's locked. Hang on, I've got a bypass shunt program that can crack it. Farron.
Liara?
Hold on. We're getting you out of here.
No.
Farron.
I thought this looked too easy.
This chair plugs into the broker's info network. You have to shut off the power. Pull me out now and my brain cooks.
Do you know where we can cut the power?
It won't be easy. You'll have to go to Central Operations.
What do you know about the broker?
He did this to me.
I was hoping you'd know what he is.
I never got a good look, but he's big. The guards are terrified of him.
A Krogan?
I don't know, but not everyone who visits his office comes back out.
What's the point of this cage?
I don't...
It's a neural grounding rod. The medical equipment is to make sure he doesn't expire. We have to shut this place down.
If he left you alive for us to find, the broker has no idea how dangerous we are.
Don't underestimate him. He prepares for everything. Central operations is down the hall. You know the Shadow Broker's waiting for you, right?
I'm counting on it. That bombing on Ilium wasn't exactly subtle.
Extreme, but necessary.
No, it wasn't. Neither was caging Farron for 2 years.
Dr. Tassoni, your interference caused all this. Farron betrayed me when he handed you Shepard's body. The Drell is simply paying the price.
It'll be pretty hard to run a base this size with no crew.
They're replaceable. Your arrival is barely an interruption.
Someone was bound to come after you for working with the Collectors.
It was a mutually beneficial partnership. Your arrival is convenient. The Collector's offer still stands. Enough talk. My operations are too crucial to be compromised by a traitor.
You're quite confident for someone with nowhere left to hide.
You travel with fascinating companions, Doctor. Bringing an assassin was shrewd, Tassoni. I'll give Mr. Krios' son my regards.
You're not putting a hand on anyone.
It's pointless to challenge me, Asari. I know your every secret, while you fumble in the dark.
Is that right? You're a Yogg, a pre-space flight species quarantined to their homeworld for massacring the Council's first contact teams. This base is older than your planet's discovery, which probably means you killed the original Shadow Broker 60 years ago, then took over. I'm guessing you were taken from your world by a trophy hunter who wanted a slave. Or a pet. How am I doing?
Shadow Broker, this is Operative Morat. We've had a momentary connection failure. Can you confirm status?
Operative Shora requesting update. Are we still online?
Shadow Broker, I've lost our feed. We're online and awaiting instructions.
Okay.
Momentarily.
However, we are now back online. Resume standard procedures.
I want a status report on all operations within the next solar day.
Shadow Broker, out.
Goddess of Oceans, it's you. You... how?
Well, everyone who's ever seen him in person is dead, so...
It'll be nice to have access to information I can trust, Broker.
I'm not sure I'm ready for you to call me that. I'm not sure about any of this, but I had to do it. With the Shadow Broker's information network, I can give you...
I'll check the power systems.
It's over. It's finally. For 2 years.
It's all right.
It's been 2 years. I don't... We're different people. You have your mission, and... Okay. But we should focus. Let's see what our options are. No safeguards or user restrictions. It's like he never anticipated anyone but himself being here. And it's all ours.
Sure you want to stay here? I could use you on the Normandy.
I have to stay here. We can't pass this up, Shepard. All I wanted was to rescue Farron, but... is it wrong that part of me wants this? With the Shadow Broker's network, I can help you. Maybe I can turn this operation into something better.
Don't be a stranger this time.
Small chance of that. Come back soon.
Need something?
Have a few minutes to talk?
Certainly.
If you don't mind my saying, you don't really seem like an assassin.
You've spent too much time fighting thugs who think custom-painted armor makes them professionals. The Hanar trained my body for this role since I was 6 years old.
You've been killing since you were six?
Of course not. I didn't make my first kill until I was 12. They were training me. I was not to be used and thrown away. I was an investment.
You were a child. Not an investment.
I've given you the wrong idea. They valued me, yes, as a resource, but also as a person. They regretted their need for me.
The Hanar? Excessively polite, worship the Protheans? They don't seem the type who'd train assassins.
Every species trains assassins. The Hanar are only unusual in that they need other species to do the killing for them. They have a strong grip and natural toxins, but... have you ever seen one move quickly outside of water? Or fire a gun.
Why did your parents agree to this?
The agreement was made under the Compact. It was an honor for our family.
The Compact?
We live on the Hanar homeworld because they rescued us, some of us, from extinction. We owe them our lives. That is the Compact.
What exactly are the terms of the Compact?
There are many things the Hanar can't do, even with mechanical aid. They ask Drell to assist them.
The way you describe it, the Hanar sound like weaklings.
Out here, they are. But if you could see them in the encompassing, the oceans of Kaje, you would see them differently. A stream of silver in the dark, looping, diving. So fast the eye can't follow. Laughter like the squeals of a child vibrates the water. They fly over the black of the seabed like birds, plumed with the light of heaven.
This can't be legal. They made your whole race into slaves.
Don't insult me, Shepard. Anyone can refuse to serve. Few do. We owe our existence to the Hanar. We are proud to repay the debt.
Why was your race going extinct?
Overpopulation. That must sound trite to you.
Humans developed Mass Effect Drive before the problem became acute. Our homeworld, Rakana, had few resources. We hadn't even developed fusion power when the soil began to fail from overuse and pollution. The Hanar found us a century ago. They sent hundreds of ships, evacuated thousands of us. Billions more had to be left behind.
What's the state of Rakana now?
Do you read your philosophers? A man named Thomas Hobbes? When all the world is overcharged with inhabitants, then the last remedy of all is war, which provideth for every man by victory or death. As Rakana died around them, my people slaughtered each other for mouthfuls of water, crumbs of food.
But you don't kill for the Hanar anymore. You're freelance. What changed?
I was asleep for a long time, yes. I paid no attention to what my body was asked to do, but then... Laser Dot trembles on the skull. One finger twitch, he dies. Then, the smell of spice on the spring wind. Sunset-colored eyes defiant in the scope. The laser dances away.
Excuse me, you know where I can find Serena?
She's not here anymore. Oh, you're the one she was helping out. She took a job off-world. Didn't say where. She gave me something for you. Looks like a message.
She didn't say anything else?
She just gave me that and left. Not even a goodbye.
Hey, Shepard. I was on my way to a new life when the new burst arrived. The bitch is dead. I assume that means your friend is alive and he finished his job. Tell him if I ever see him, I'll buy him a drink.
Can I help you with something?
I'm looking for an Asari warrior named Samara.
Wait, why? Do you have a problem, or did she kill somebody already?
I have no idea. Just tell me where she is.
If you insist, but fair warning, watch yourself around Samara. Justicars have a nasty habit of shooting people. She went to the commercial spaceport a few hours ago. If you want to get there, the pedestal on that balcony will summon a cab. Just be polite when you meet her. Justicars embody our highest laws, and they usually stay in Asari space. She's not used to dealing with aliens.
Is Samara really that dangerous?
If you follow the laws, you've got nothing to fear, and a Justicar would die without hesitation to protect the innocent. But their code orders them to stop lawbreakers, with lethal force in most cases. And everyone skirts the law somehow on Ilium. If someone tried to bribe her, she'd be obliged to gun them down as a matter of honor. I'm hoping to avoid that.
Why are you worried about other species coming into contact with her?
If a Justicar kills an Asari, none of us questions it. But if she killed a human... Do you think the Alliance would understand her actions and respect her authority? You can't even figure out your own religions! It's a big, diplomatic incident just waiting to happen.
Tell me about the Justicars.
They're a monastic order. They've given up their families and possessions to follow their code. Most of them are on some lifelong mission, but they'll always stop to deal with any injustice they encounter, which can be a problem. In some ways, they're a lot like the Spectres, undertaking personal missions.
Spectres are authorized by the Council. Who do Justicars represent?
What? That's like, I don't know, a good human metaphor. They represent their code, our code. It's closer to a religious group than a legal branch. No law-abiding Asari would question a Justicar's orders. Nobody becomes a Justicar for personal gain. And they die before breaking their oaths.
Where do you think you're going?
I'm taking my goods to Omega, Detective.
You're not going anywhere, Merchant. Not until I solve this murder.
I had nothing to do with that. It was those mercenary thugs you can't seem to get rid of.
The victim was your business partner, and I'm not ruling you out. I'll let you know when you can leave.
What about that Justicar that just showed up? Everyone says she might go crazy and start killing. I need to leave.
She'll only kill the unjust, so I'm sure you have nothing to worry about, Pitney Four. Find me in the station if you need me.
What do you want? I've already got mercs wanting to kill me like they did my partner. I don't need any more trouble. As if that weren't enough, some Asari Justicar showed up this morning. All the natives are scared of her. I've got to get off of this world.
Has Samara actually done anything yet?
The Asari say that Justicars are lethal in a fight. And if they so much as smell corruption, they start shooting. The thing is, corruption isn't that hard to find around here.
Tell me how to find the Justicar.
She's in the alley where my business partner was murdered.
Nice guns. Try not to use them in my district. What can I do for you?
I'm looking for an Asari warrior named Samara.
If you've got a score to settle with Samara, take it somewhere else. I've got more than enough trouble here already.
I need to find Samara and get back to my mission, with or without your help.
Sounds important. Justicars usually work alone, but they are drawn to impossible causes.
How convenient for us.
If you're getting her out of my district, I'll get you to her ASAP. She's at the crime scene.
You're letting her into a sealed crime scene?
I'm a cop. I'll work with the Justicar all I can. Besides, she's been looking at crime scenes longer than our two lifespans combined. She knows how to handle herself.
You're awfully anxious to get Samara out of your district.
My bosses want me to detain her. They're worried she'll cause some kind of cross-species incident. But her Justicar code won't let her be taken into custody. If I try it, she'll have to kill me. I have no interest in dying, so if you lure her away with some big noble cause before I have to carry out my orders, I'm thrilled to help you.
Samara would kill a cop? That doesn't sound very just.
She would die defending an honest cop, but she'd fight an army of dirty cops to the death. I admire her dedication, but her presence is still a big problem. I need her gone before I have to carry out my orders.
Your superiors are sending you to certain death for no good reason. You have a right to disobey.
Let's remember that next time Shepard sets us up against impossible odds.
That's about twice a day.
Most of the time I'm not being stupid about it. I can't say the same for Anaya's superiors.
I'm a cop and I know my duty. I've been ordered to detain her and I will. Unless I can get her to leave my district first.
How do I get to the crime scene?
It's around the corner. Go outside, take a left. Look for the police line, I'll send word to let you in. Be careful. The local Eclipse mercs have been all over those back alleys lately.
I have to go.
Good luck.
Those were my best troops.
Tell me what I need to know, and I will be gone from here. Where did you send her?
You think I'd betray her? She would hurt me in ways you can't imagine.
The name of the ship. Your life hangs on the answer, Lieutenant.
You can kill me, but one of us will take you down, Justicar!
What was the name of the ship she left on?
Go to hell!
Find peace in the embrace of the goddess. My name is Samara, a servant of the Justicar Code. My quarrel is with these Eclipse sisters, but I see three well-armed people before me. Are we friend or foe?
That merc was wounded and helpless. Do you just kill anyone who won't help you?
If my cause is important enough, yes. Are you different?
I can't say that I am.
That is something we share. You are honest, that is another. How may I be of service to you?
I'm going up against suicidal odds, and I need the best. That's you.
I sense the truth in what you say, and it humbles me. But I seek an incredibly dangerous fugitive. I cornered her here, but the Eclipse sisters smuggled her off-world. I must find the name of the ship she left on before the trail goes cold.
I wish you were willing to go with the human, Justicar. I've been ordered to take you into custody if you won't leave.
You risk a great deal by following your orders, Detective. Fortunately, I will not have to resist. My code obligates me to cooperate with you for one day. After that, I must return to my investigation.
I won't be able to release you that soon.
You won't be able to stop me.
The human is lost here. Can one of you clarify?
I was trying to convince her to leave with you, but Justicar is in their code.
The detective has been ordered to detain me. I can't force her to disobey an order.
And after one day, Samara fights her way out of custody, killing anyone in her way.
I am afraid so.
I'll get the name of that ship.
Do that, and I will join you. Then the code will be satisfied.
Can you tell me more about Justicars?
We are individuals who have forsworn family, children, and worldly possessions aside from some weapons and armor. We travel Asari space righting wrongs as defined by the ancient code we have each memorized.
Ilium may be dominated by Asari, but it isn't in Asari space.
My quarry fled to this place. I am sworn to hunt her down, and I will follow anywhere she goes. It is rare for a Justicar to leave Asari space, but I must follow my oath. If I suffer for it, I will accept that.
A moment ago you refused to give up your investigation, but now you'll swear to follow me?
If I stay, I will be compelled to kill many innocents to escape incarceration.
Like me.
I may be killed, and my quarry would be free to continue murdering. If I come with you and survive your mission, I can resume my investigation. To do that, I need the ship's name to track her to her next hiding place. It is a simple choice.
A slim chance is better than no chance.
Do you have any leads?
The Volus merchant Pitney IV is tied to this. Eclipse mercs are preparing to kill him. Get the truth out of him. He may know a way into the Eclipse base.
Well, I've got to get back to my station. And I guess I've got to take you with me.
Thank you, Shepard.
Scanning.
Hello again, Earth Clan. Did you speak to the detective?
You said you didn't know anything about all this. You've got one chance to change that statement.
What do you mean, Earth? Oh dear. Please put that away. I'll be cooperative, I swear.
Tell me everything.
I smuggled a chemical onto Ilium that boosts biotic powers in combat. It also is toxic. I may have, forgotten to mention that to the Eclipse. So they are perturbed and want to kill me.
It sounds like you're a swindler and your actions finally caught up with you.
True and true. But I haven't survived as a merchant this long without being able to tell when there's a deal in the making. You want something.
I need to break into the Eclipse base.
I do have a pass card they issued me to bring my goods in. Well, I had to return that one, but I happened to make a copy. Take it, but be careful. Each Eclipse sister commits a murder to earn her uniform. They are all dangerous.
I didn't fire my weapon once. I pretended to because the other Eclipse sisters were watching, but I didn't really shoot. I'm not one of them. I'm new. I thought being Elnora the mercenary would be cool, but I didn't know what they were really like.
You chose your side, Elnora. And you lost. This looks like a shipping manifest. It shows the Pitney IV sold 2,000 units of Minigen X3 to the Eclipse. Along with 600 units of red sand.
This isn't the information Samara needs, but it proves the Volus is a criminal.
I am a biotic god. I think things, and they happen. Fear me, lesser creatures, for I am biotics made flesh.
I don't know what drugs you're on, but stay back and I won't shoot you.
You will regret your scandalous words. I am a great wind that will sweep all before me like a great wind. A great biotic wind. Yes, the Asari injecting so many drugs into me was terrifying. But then I began to smell my greatness. They may laugh when I fall over, but they don't know what I know in my head. That I know that I am amazingly powerful. Fear me!
Are you part of Pitney Forest Trade Group?
When I was mortal, I worked for Pitney. Poor soul is probably terrified that I have not returned.
He hasn't reported your disappearance. Probably so his departure won't get delayed.
I get the distinct impression Pitney prefers money to friends.
Bah! I will wreak a just revenge upon his people. But first, the leader of these mercenaries is in the next room. I shall toss Wasea about like a rag doll.
Shepard, he can barely talk, much less fight.
I will tear her apart. My biotics are unstoppable.
Charge.
An ill wind blows upon Wasea, captain of the Eclipse Sisters. After me!
Everything's gone to hell since we smuggled that filthy creature off-world. First a Justicar shows up. Now you. At least I can take pleasure in turning your head into a pulpy mass!
I've got the name of the ship. Your fugitive left here 2 days ago on the AML Demeter.
Shepard, you impress me. You fulfilled your part of the bargain, and I will fulfill mine. I am ready to leave immediately, if that will satisfy your superiors, Detective.
You're free to go, Justicar. It has been an honor having you in my station. And it's nice you didn't kill me, too.
You're sworn to follow a code that dictates your decisions. But I'm running a military operation.
You wonder if I will refuse to follow orders because of my code?
I can't allow that to happen.
By agreeing to follow you, I am compelled to swear the most difficult of Justicar oaths, the third oath of subsummation. After I do, your orders will override the code. You should know, however, that I'll still give you my opinion if the situation warrants.
The Normandy is docked near the main trading floor. I'll see you aboard.
I must be sworn to your service so that I am never forced to choose between your orders and the code. By the code, I will serve you, Shepard. Your choices are my choices. Your morals are my morals. Your wishes are my code.
Welcome to the Normandy, Samara. We've studied your profile extensively. With your skills, I think you'll be an excellent addition to our team.
Thank you. From an organization such as yours, that is high praise indeed.
With what we're planning, we need all the experienced people we can get.
We still don't know what we're going to find when we hit the collectors.
I will be prepared for whatever we encounter.
Where shall we put you?
A room that looks out on the great empty void would be most comforting.
Put her in the observation room on Deck 3.
Thank you. I must meditate on the day's events. Shepard.
How are you?
I've spent much of the last 400 years on my own. It is nice to have a colleague to chat with. I may be rusty at it, however. If you are patient, I would love to talk.
How much do you know about our mission?
I know that I've sworn an oath to follow you, and that you seek to destroy the Collectors. That is enough for me.
You don't want to know why the Collectors need to be fought?
When you live by a code that compels you to harsh action, you learn the dangers of curiosity. If I must kill a man because he has done wrong, do I really wish to know that he is a devoted father?
What do you think of Cerberus?
I've heard rumors, but learned long ago to form my own impressions. There is too much room for interpretation in the opinions of others.
Why were you willing to work for Cerberus when you didn't have first-hand knowledge?
I work for you, Shepard. Our methods may be different, but our goals are not.
I'd like to hear more about the criminal you were chasing on Nos Astra.
I hope you will understand if I wish to avoid this topic. It is deeply tied to my code and beliefs. You might say it is personal.
I need to know if this will impact the mission.
It will not.
Shepard, it's so good to see you. I've set up a few terminals with information I think you'll find interesting. Take a look.
Welcome back, Shadow Broker.
What's this?
That's the old Broker's VI assistant. It's actually been helpful with rebuilding the network.
Please let me know if I can organize anything else for you, Shadow Broker.
It also thinks anyone in the room is the Broker. I'll play around with the settings later.
My manual is ready whenever you have a moment.
What does this console do?
This is the video surveillance access point. I've queued up the archive footage you requested on your last visit, Shadow Broker. Arya Tlok, Omega. Emily Wong, Citadel.
How are you doing, Liara?
I'm a bit overwhelmed, to be honest. The Shadow Broker had more resources than you can imagine. Here, come on over. He had top-level access to the Turian and Asari governments. And more than one Salarian Dalatros traded intel. At least I get to share it with you.
If you're in over your head, we could just crash this thing and walk away.
That's just it. In a way, I feel like I belong here. Working on my own, I was always hunting for leads. With the Shadow Broker's resources, it's about organizing, cataloging. I've got everything, Shepard. This is a dream job. Although, the location could be better.
You're not gonna turn into a recluse with creepy information on everyone in the galaxy, are you?
I can understand the temptation. I've got all the secrets of the galaxy at my fingertips. Give me 10 minutes and I could start a war. But I've got a purpose, helping you stop the Reapers. That will keep me honest. You know, relatively speaking.
Have you found anything useful yet?
The Shadow Broker knew about the Reapers. Perhaps that's why he offered to help prove Saren's guilt to the Council.
He didn't want Saren to succeed.
He knew you weren't lying about your visions of the Prothean beacon. There's even some data on the Protheans. I think he knew what was coming and was looking for a way to survive.
Why was he still looking at Protheans? They gave us the warning and the conduit at Ilos, but we've used those.
The Shadow Broker seemed to think there was more out there. Perhaps the Protheans had other plans. Or maybe he was just grasping at anything that offered some hope.
How'd you know what the Shadow Broker was?
I didn't. I had no idea what to expect when we finally found him. But I researched pre-spaceflight cultures during some of my Prothean studies. I know a bit about the Yogg. There's more on the terminals if you want to look. They're a fascinating culture, and a terrifying one.
You know, I didn't come down here just to talk about data.
Look, About the kiss. We just finished the fight. I miss you, but it's been 2 years. I don't want to put pressure on you.
I've got fond memories of the last time you put pressure on me.
So do I.
Why don't you come to the Normandy for drinks?
I'd like that.
Good. Get your things and come on up.
Okay, thanks. I'll be right there. Just give me a minute.
Did you enjoy the tour?
Yes, it's a beautiful ship. And I ran into Joker. He seemed happy to see me. Although, he did ask me to record any parts of our conversation where my eyes do that freaky black eternity thing.
Of course he did.
I also spoke with Dr. Chakwas. I'm glad she's doing well. I brought you something. It took some digging, but I recovered your tags.
It seems like forever since I was an Alliance soldier. First I got tapped for the Spectres, now Cerberus.
You succeed against odds most people wouldn't even take on. It's no wonder everyone wants you on their side. But I know it wears on you. So, how are you doing, Shepard? I mean, really. Not what you tell your squad to keep morale up.
Honestly, I'm tired. Tired of dealing with Cerberus. Tired of the Council ignoring me. Tired of my closest friends not believing me.
Yes, I heard about what Ashley said on Horizon. I'm sorry. But their short-sightedness doesn't diminish what you've accomplished. There wouldn't be a man, woman, or child left on Horizon, if not for you.
You know the worst part of it? Cerberus planted intel to lure the Collectors there. Horizon was bait.
Those bastards.
They'd have hit another world if we hadn't lured them there, but aren't you gonna tell me not to work with them?
I gave them your body, remember? What should I say? And I trust you. You'll stick to your beliefs no matter what Cerberus wants. So tell me what you want. If this all ends tomorrow, what happens to us?
I don't know. Marriage, old age, and a lot of little blue children?
You just say these things. Goddess, you were dead.
I got better.
This time, but you're going to leave again. When your team is ready, you'll leap through the Omega 4 relay. I spent 2 years mourning you. So if we're going to try this, I need to know you're always coming back.
I don't know. That's a pretty big promise to make.
Oh, is it?
I'd have to have something special to come back to.
I'm open to suggestions.
How about this?
Come fly with me, let's fly away. If you can use some exotic booze, there's a bar in far Bombay. Come on and fly with me. Let's fly away. Come fly with me, let's float down to Peru.